As this pandemic goes on and on, we learn more and more, and we have new medicine and vaccines. But on the flip side, new variants emerge and the data becomes more complicated, which leads to more questions that become even harder to answer. When it comes to different variants and different vaccines and number of shots of vaccines and immunity from previous infection, things get exponentially confusing. But it looks like we have some clarity when it comes to the Pfizer vaccine against Omicron. And on a related note, based on a preprint study which has not been peer-reviewed yet, it does look like that despite Omicron having 32 mutations that help it escape the antibodies of the immune system, it still does a poor job of escaping our T cells. So the T cells are a major part of our immune system that acts as a second-line defense, just like in football. In test tube studies, researchers in South Africa exposed copies of the virus to the T cells that were taken from people who received either the Pfizer or the J&J vaccine, as well as those who had not been vaccinated but did develop immunity from previous COVID infection. The conclusion from this study was that T cell immunity to the Omicron variant from either natural immunity from previous infection or from vaccines is well preserved. And then we have another study that was peer-reviewed, published in the New England Journal of Medicine just a couple days ago, that shows that two shots of the Pfizer vaccine prevents most people from being hospitalized with the Omicron variant of COVID. The data shows that the effectiveness of the two doses against Omicron did slightly drop compared to Delta, but overall, it remains effective, about 70% effective at preventing hospitalizations. Yes, Omicron has been found in several other studies that cause many more infections in those who are vaccinated and boosted, and of course those who are unvaccinated as well. In South Africa, most of the hospitalizations occurred in the unvaccinated. The rates of COVID hospitalization during the Omicron timeframe were lower compared to the Delta timeframe. Hospitalization rates were anywhere from 2 to 6 times lower during the Omicron period, depending on the age group. So why is this the case? There are two main factors at play here. One is that there's higher vaccination rates during the Omicron timeframe. And two, there's a lower average age of those becoming infected during the Omicron timeframe, meaning young adults make up a higher percentage of hospitalizations compared to before. So these two factors are known as confounding variables, which muddies the water when trying to figure out if Omicron is truly a milder infection compared to Delta. So is this the Omicron variant itself that's less dangerous than Delta? Even as we enter 2022, this is actually still unclear.